the stand clerk says, well, in that case, he said, I'll buy you a car. Now, at this point, the leader's alarm bell should have clanged incredibly loudly. Is it really appropriate for me to be receiving a car from, say, Uttoxeter Reservoir? To be receiving
a car. Go straight ahead at the roundabout. Second exit.
A major developer in my area. Now, people might well think that because he's giving me a car, I might be more predisposed to approve his planning application. So he might be able to think anything quite like that, but clearly people did. And so he got the car. Spent his time going around pubs and clubs in the area and trying to drum up business for the race cars. And all would have been fine except that the Burton Times, whatever the local rag is called, discovered that all this was going on and said not unreasonably, why is the leader of the Bank Council accepting what is in effect a bribe from a major developer in the area? And at this point the car went back, but of course the damage at this point had already been done. And we were asked by someone who had been opposed to planning application, which had been approved by the council in this period, with strong contributions from the leader in favour of the application, to try and determine whether in fact the whole thing was corrupt, the leader had done what he was doing because of the car, or whether he'd approved it on material planning. So we went to see Stack, several of our investigators. And had to interview him as much, which I didn't even see that many people to. But the strange part about it was we went into his office, and I realised that the furniture in the office was standard local authority furniture from a council chamber. And I kind of looked at him, and he looked at me, and he said, you're looking at the furniture, aren't you? And I said, I'm looking at the furniture, yes. He said, you're right, it said it came from Burton on Trent Town Hall. He said they were throwing it out. And I said, I'd have it. So it ended up as being quite funny. But we duly reported. But in the end, we were convinced that the planning application was properly approved. But actually, there was a lot going for this planning application. The officers had recommended it. So there wasn't any maladministration, but it was well worth the report to point out that high-ranking politicians should not be accepting plans, developers in their area.
Right, Stu, you can send a message to Jenny. Someone's just sent that, a vanny teacher.
I don't want to, just leave it alone. I think Stevie wants to go for a snoozle.
She said, thank you so much, Jane, for sending the most beautiful photographs of Jenny and her husband. Many congratulations to you all. Please send my love. That's Miss Kay.
Morning.
After 800 yards, go straight ahead at the roundabout. Second exit. Go straight ahead at the roundabout. Second exit.
Asda?
No.
Atfield? Anton Deck? Alligator?
Message received. Do you want to hear it?
Yes.
well, they posted them 1 minute ago. Age 67.
Do we get a name? Or is this a
George.
I knew he'd been. He's been unwell for some time.
What?
Cancer, as I recall.
Cancer, yeah.
So it comes as no surprise.
Not the one that was getting pictures of a 17-year-old.
The full truth of that hasn't come out yet. I'm still not convinced he's done anything wrong.
I don't know. Maybe not legally, but a bit weird morally.
But it's the legal bit. Yes, I mean, it may. The question is it unwise, or is it actually illegal? The police have concluded it's not illegal.
It's a little bit weird if now they're saying that the woman has drug problems.
We still don't know whether it was a boy or a girl he was sending photographs. He was wanting photographs of.
Still though, it's a bit weird. And it seems convenient that they can just go, you can get away from it for saying you have mental health issues.
But consulting adults are allowed to do things with them.
They said they were 17 though.
Well, we're not entirely sure about that. The Sun thought so, but we don't know how much evidence they got, because we know that the Sun had got no evidence from the victim at all.
I said the family kicked off about it.
The family kicked off, but this young person was an adult by then, perfectly capable of managing her own affairs, and allegedly told the Sun that there was no truth in it on the publication day, so the Sun should probably have at least printed the denial, and arguably not run the story at all.
Ahead, keep right.
Someone at the Sun really got a rush of blood to the head without thinking this one through. So I feel a bit sorry for Hugh Edwards, because I'm not sure, no, Evans, because I'm not sure he's done anything wrong. See, here's Toyota. This is where Toyota live for now. They'll be closing up before too long because of Brexit. Most UK car manufacturers.
After 800 yards, keep right. Keep right.
taking the mick, mother. No, you don't. You can use whatever you want. You shouldn't believe what Dad says, as mean, Dad.
The best thing for screens is actually Lark's monitor. It's just a bit different.
You can use what you said, mother.
You can get a synthesised Lark's monitor.
No, Dad, this has been.
Oh, God, it says Rose Blaze.
same in Corfu as well. Lots of these people simply won't get holidays because there's only so much available holiday accommodation out there at the Mighton School holidays. If the flights can be sorted out, there won't be any hotel space available.
Is it looking for the migrants away with the one file?
Well, no, it won't.
They'll run into the fire.
No, they'll want to get here even more because they know we don't have random forest fires that destroy their homes. The hope is obviously that we're going to give them which we've got lots of.
We don't.
Sorry?
We don't.
Now, if you're a migrant sitting there in these places, thinking, where shall I go next? The UK is quite my own list.
I say we should share them out equally in Europe and the EU should send them all to Poland.
There was an EU agreement that said exactly that, unfortunately. To tear wind of the Conservative Party didn't like that, so we derogated from it. The Dublin Agreement.
Just send them all to Poland and Romania.
And under the Dublin Agreement, you could return. Migrants had to claim asylum in the first
Someone's
country.
Someone's vandalised the Leicestershire sign. That's not very nice.
Under the Dublin Agreement, migrants had to claim asylum in the first European country they entered. So if they hadn't done that, you could reject their claim. And if they had done that, you would send them back to that country. It's a perfectly sensible arrangement. But of course, the Brexiteer win at the
Exit right ahead.
Donington Park down. Hi, Mama.
Sweets, I gave you the packet on the way down.
Yeah, but you there on top.
I can't give you other sweets.
No, it's all right, I've got them in the bag. I'm sure I've got them in the bag somewhere.
Mum's got the sweets.
So we are in the vicinity of East Midlands Airport now, so you might see some aeroplanes.
You didn't decide what we're going to have for dinner then.
Lunch or dinner?
Dinner.
Well, I can have Chinese if you want to buy something.
Oh, you know, you're on Tesco lunch.
After 800 yards, take the exit right, then go straight on.
That's his lorry, but no,
you stop at the big Tesco.
Which one?
I don't know, which is the closest big Tesco?
Take the exit right, then go straight on. After 400 yards, go straight on, then take the exit right. Go straight on, then take the exit right.
Hello?
After 400 yards, take the exit right,
yes.
Then take the motorway.
I can't hear you.
Take the exit right, then take the motorway.
My boiler service?
Yes. Can I get booked in with the impossible?
Sure, what is it? You're from Corgi then? Sorry.
I am.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, sorry, I couldn't hear you.
That's okay. Are you free on the 11th of August at all in the afternoon?
I don't know. Is it possible I can ring you back?
No problem at all.
Later today, when I've got my work timetable.